Dear students, today I am going to discuss the remaining topics of assisted reproductive technology. In previous video, I discussed IVF, embryo transfer technique, intrauterine insemination. Today I am going to discuss the following topics: zygote intrafallopian transfer. Zygote intrafallopian transfer, that means the short form is ZIFT, zygote intrafallopian transfer. The second topic is intrauterine transfer. Intrauterine transfer. Third one is gamete intrafallopian transfer, GIFT, gamete intrafallopian transfer. Fourth one, intracytoplasmic sperm injection, ICSI, intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Fifth topic is surrogacy. Now I am going to discuss zygote intrafallopian transfer, ZIFT. Here the zygote up to 8 blastomere. What is blastomere? Already I told you in the previous video. Up to 8 blastomere stage is transferred into the fallopian tube. The very important term is fallopian tube. Fallopian tube. By laparoscopy. What is meant by laparoscopy? Minimally invasive surgery. A small opening is made. Through that opening, the surgery will be carried out. Now, after this transfer, the zygote undergoes divisions, migrate to uterus for implantation. See this picture. Here the blastomere, that is the zygote, it is transferred here in the fallopian tube. Here it is mentioned IVF zygotes placed into the oviduct. Oviduct nothing but the fallopian tube. In this it is placed. After the certain development, it will move towards the uterus for implantation. The next heading is intrauterine transfer. Intrauterine transfer. The term itself indicates the implantation done directly to the uterus. Embryo with more than 8 blastomere, embryo with more than 8 blastomeres is inserted into the uterus for further development. See here in this picture, the embryo directly introduced into the uterus, not in the fallopian tube. You can see clearly in the previous picture I showed you, the embryo is, that is the, here the zygote is introduced into the fallopian tube, but here it is directly introduced into the uterus. Now the next topic is gamete intra fallopian transfer. See the term gamete, gift method. Gamete is important term. So far I told you the embryo. Now I am using the term gamete. You know already what is gamete? Egg and the sperms. Not the zygote. Clearly you have to understand that. Here we are transferring the egg and the sperm into the fallopian tube. Ovum collected from the ovaries placed with the sperms in fallopian tube. See in this picture, sperm and eggs are placed into a fallopian tube. See the sperms and the eggs. It is directly placed into the fallopian tube. After attaining certain stages, that is the division, the zygote will move towards the uterus. Then the development will start. Ovum collected from the ovaries, placed with the sperms in the fallopian tubes. See here, these are the ovaries. From these ovaries, the eggs are collected and it will be introduced, it will be placed here, and sperm also collected and it will be placed here. Here the fertilization will take over, and after the fertilization and after attaining certain zygote stage, that is after attaining the embryonic stage, it will move towards the uterus and here the implantation will take over. Now the topic is intracytoplasmic sperm injection. ICSI, intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Here only one sperm is injected carefully into the focal point of the egg to fertilize. Only one sperm is injected carefully into the focal point of the egg to fertilize. Here, if it is a egg, and here only one sperm is introduced here. Fertilization occurs in 75% to 85% of eggs injected with the sperms. 75% to 85% of eggs injected with the sperms. After this process, zygote divides and form 8-celled blastomeres. Then transfer to the uterus for further development. See this picture. Intracytoplasmic sperm injection, ICSI. In this I told you only one sperm is injected carefully into the focal point of the egg to fertilize. See here in this picture, only one sperm is introduced into the egg cytoplasm. After this, the fertilization will over, and after the fertilization, the zygote formation will happen. After the zygote formation, and it divides and forms the 8-celled blastomere, and it will be introduced into the uterus, and the development will carried out. The final heading which I am going to discuss now is surrogacy. Surrogacy means a woman agrees to carry a pregnancy for another person who will become the newborn child's parent after birth. This method is carried out through IVF. The embryos will be developed. These embryos will be transferred to the surrogate mother. See this picture. These parents want to have the child, but they couldn't develop a child on their own because of some problems. So they can donate their egg and the sperm to this layer, that is for fertilization in the laboratory condition. After the zygote formation, it will be introduced into the another woman, a surrogate mother. She is called the surrogate mother, and it will be introduced into her. And after the complete development, after the delivery, that baby will be given to this parents. This is called surrogacy. Students, I hope the headings which I have discussed so far will be beneficial for you. Once again, I tell you the headings: zygote intra-fallopian transfer, intrauterine transfer, gamete intra-fallopian transfer, intracytoplasmic sperm injection, surrogacy. All the best, students.